My name is Vasudeva Varma. I teach at TyE Hyderabad. I'm a professor as well as the dean of research there, but also have a long entrepreneurial journey which I'm going to share with that, share that very soon, but then after the introductions, right?
Okay. So you heard me in the morning. My name is Sangha Reddy. I'm one of the core committee members as well. So I'll share my interview journey later, but briefly I run a startup called Safe to Serve.
Hi, I'm Suman Randamashyam. I'll be taking the simulation session for you. Where I'll be in the background, I'll give you a company to run. It will be a failed business, and we'll give you 5 to 8 financial years to turn around the company. It's going to be action-packed, hands-on learning. You do the work, you decide, you dream, you have the idea, you implement. That's going to be our exciting journey in this session. Thank you.
So this is a three-member team. We also have Subhash, who is traveling today. This four-member team is the core TyE team. So any questions, right? Anything related to the program, if you write an email to tye@hyderabadtye.org, right? Four of us, Subhash missing, but four of us will be able to get that email and we'll be able to respond back to you and help clarify anything related to TYE, right? And we are glad to have volunteers. These are the people that like the program so much that they volunteered their time to be here and to help us with the program.
Hi everybody, I'm Sanjay. I'm myself an entrepreneur. I run two startups. One is Strawberry People, which is into education. Other is OFO, we're into food delivery and all. And we like to spend time with you all. Feel free to reach us for any kind of support if you need.
Hi everyone, I'm Vivek. I guess I'm the one who's been emails. I work with TyE. I'm in the backend staff, the support staff of TyE. But so any help that you require apart from the core team, or any help that you require in terms of what the sessions are going to be about, what can we can give you, if there's anything else, feedback that you want.
So please expect some emailers from any one of the volunteers here, and you know how to reach us if you need the core TyE team, right? That's part of our introductions, and then quickly we have we now have a small introduction about ourselves to talk about our own journey, right? And the four of us who are trying to do this program, we've been entrepreneurs for quite some time, and we want to share our own story, and then we'll be open for Q&A, right? If you have any questions, anything that you want us to discuss, go ahead, right? First, we'll have Professor Vasudeva Varma talk about his entrepreneurial journey.
Hey, just got into the afternoon. Good afternoon. And what I would like to share with you,
is this better?
This is better.
Without mic is better?
If mic is better? Okay, good. So, what I'll do in next 5 to 10 minutes, is talk about some of the interesting things that I found on the journey. You remember, you've been learning, you've been hearing this term journey. Nobody is talking about the destination, right? Rajiv is also talking about the journey. And most of the times you'll only hear this word journey. Why is that heard so often? Any idea? One single reason. Journey is more important than the destination. Want to say something?
The journey leads to the destination.
Journey
leads to the destination.
journey has to lead to a destination, right? And more often, you're not thrilled by after reaching the destination. When you come back, when you think about it, you'll actually think about the good things that have happened to you during the journey. So the journey is lot more fun, lot more pleasure, okay? Lot more rewarding than reaching the destination. How many of you feel that you are just like anybody else? Like doing your regular study, you'll be like one among many people. How many of you feel that way? Then I would have expected all the hands to raise in the for my first question, right? So Rajiv said he wanted to be a Superman. Each one of us, we know that when we were growing up, most of you feel you're grown ups already, right? So when you are growing up, did you feel that you are special? You are the princess or the prince of the house, and then many people told you that you are like something different, right? That's the case with every person on earth. Most of us, when we were growing up, at least fly and be a Superman. But I always thought, maybe I'm another incarnation of God. I'm serious, right? Because I've been hearing about all these stories people used to tell me, and my grandfather used to tell me about all the, stories of Ramayana and all that. He actually inculcated that feeling that you are special. Okay? Then I used to believe that maybe I'm really special, and I used to go to a big garden and then meditate for some time, thinking that God will really come and tell me what is the purpose that. Right? But then the important thing here is all of you, I'm sure, will have your own imaginations. If you're only watching TV, you're only reading your books, and have very little time for imagination, then you are wasting your childhood. You have enough time for you where your mind lets you free. So from there, I studied in Telugu medium till 10, and afterwards it was in English medium, but we never understood what was being told. Then later, I went to Goa for the studies after my 12. That's when, without going swimming, you are actually not just pushed into the swimming pool, but into the ocean. You need to survive. So right at the beginning, right at the foundation days, there are these ups and downs. One time you feel you are a special person, you are completely different. And then other place that you see, you are nobody. Right? You need to really struggle hard even to communicate to a mess worker to give you the right food. And then because there's a feeling inside you that there's a belief that you are special, you can't be like anybody else, right? So you need to really prove to that, until you get to that point where you are treated special, where you get all the attention, you struggle. So everybody has their own ways of getting attention. Some people are good in studies, some people are good in other things. I think it's very important during your the formative years to collect as many dots as possible. You all know about this idiom called connecting the dots. Right? Have you heard about this term for connecting the dots? But how can you connect the dots if you don't collect the dots? So what are these dots? People, okay? People whom you know, right? You said it, sorry.
are these dots?
In his college at Lakemont, he used that course to design a really beautiful font for his maps. So he later on said in an interview that if I had not attended that course, probably computers would never have had beautiful text that they do. As Windows copied everything that Mac had, probably that would have never happened.
Great answer. So these dots for us are the little things that we do. Maybe you are going for a guitar class. Maybe you are playing basketball. Maybe you are learning calligraphy, G-set. Maybe you know how to paint. Maybe you are an architect. Or you know how to talk to people. You know, you are actually expert in breaking the ice, talking to strangers. All these are the small dots that you may not realize when you are doing it, but if you are a person who is not going out and then collecting these dots, at a later point of time you have nothing to connect. All these struggles, right, whether you are high, whether you are low, whether you are at home or whether you are in a completely different place, unless you collect these dots, you will not be able to connect them. So it's very important that you got to do more things that fill your jar. So that jar is the time that you have. Any of that is empty, then you are losing the opportunity to actually make use of that later. So I'm glad that you are doing something different than your school tells you to do. There are not too many of the competitions that are there today, but look, wherever those opportunities existed, was able to make use of them. Then I'm actually emphasizing the formative years more here because I hope you are all able to connect to that well. What I did later, you may or may not be able to connect. But this is very important. Then one other lesson that I have learned during this stage is nothing comes easy. Nothing comes without an effort. Everything that we have achieved, whatever that we have earned it by working very, very hard. So, there is something called, you all have homework, right? In order to be successful, there's some homework that you need to do. And that homework takes 10,000 hours. The 10,000 hours of homework, if you complete, then you will become one person who is very unique in this world. There's a book called Outliers. Steve Marshall, or something of that kind. This person actually studied several successful people in the world and then came up with this particular formula. Those who start understanding what interests them very early on and work on it for 10,000 hours, they are the ones who have become successful, they have become unique, and there was nobody like them in the world. So you can attribute that to Steve Jobs, you can attribute that to Bill Gates, you can attribute that to Michael Jordan, you can attribute that to Sachin Tendulkar. Okay? Focus 10,000 hours of homework. So if you are able to start early, then by the time you are in early 20s, you will be able to complete that homework. But if you start late, it might take 30 years. When you are 30, when you are 40, doesn't really matter, but you need to do that homework. That's very, very important. So this also kind of led me to think what I did for 10,000 hours. those 10,000 hours may not be focused on one thing, but they are related things. I really didn't study for 10,000 hours, I didn't program for 10,000 hours, which Bill Gates did. Bill Gates spent 10,000 hours programming. Okay? But then the related things that I was able to really understand at that time is about language, language technologies. How does, I was very thrilled from the very beginning with the play of the words. Starting from how, you know, I have a thought in my mind, and then how this thought is forming itself into words, and then I'm able to speak them out in real time. Right? I didn't process the sentence 10 minutes ago, and then, you know, then you got specific words that I need to use and put them in a sentence and then speak it out. And the speech generation was very thrilling. And another thing I found very fascinating is the way people play with words, like the poets, writers. I spent thousands of hours reading books, mostly in my mother tongue, in all the formative years. There was a time where any book that came to my library was actually never left alone, right, in my village, my town library. Any book that came to, those days, the best bookshop used to be in bus stands. I don't know how many of you know. I'm talking about the smaller towns, the bus stands, right, bus stop. That's where you put all the good books. Nowhere else you used to get books, right? So every time coming from school, stop at the bus stop and see if there's a new book and so on. And learning not just about what is the content, but the shape of the content, the smell of the content, smell of the language, nature of the language. These are something that actually stayed with me for a long, long time. And then later, when I was slowly introduced to computer science and so on, artificial intelligence, making machines behave like human beings, was a very fascinating idea in late 80s. Okay? That's where I caught on to the other way to connect everything, starting from the stories my grandfather used to tell me, to what these scientists are able to make these machines converse with human beings algorithmically. Right? And then, building on that, science fiction. Right? Steven Spielberg made a movie called AI. If you didn't see that, please see that movie. That movie is not so successful as far as Steven Spielberg's, you know, the movie history is concerned, but that is one of the best movies that he ever made. So making machines understand language, making machines generate language was something that is very, very fascinating. Then when I was actually doing internship at a place called National Center for Software Technologies in Mumbai, I saw for the first time a machine translation system that actually takes a news coming from Newswire, live, and then automatically translating that from English to Hindi. There's a sample system, it's not so great at that time, it made so many errors. But then the very idea that kind of changed whatever all that I wanted to do. Later I went to IIT Kanpur just to learn about language technologies with one of the best people who are actually in Kanpur, in India, who brought natural language processing systems to India. Right? So the way that I approached it, somebody from Goa, nobody would really bother to invite him to Kanpur. But then I think the reason he called me was because of my letter. At that time I didn't have email, so I wrote a long letter with my hand, expressing why I'm deeply interested in. And then, maybe something clicked. He could not have it's not necessary that those things will always be kind of will work, but this time it worked. Then went to Kanpur, then caught on to this idea, did my PhD, most of it. Then my advisor moved from Kanpur to University of Hyderabad, I moved along with him. Because advisors were more important for me than the institution. Okay? Because I could actually stay back in IIT Kanpur and then completed my PhD in a different area, but I chose something that interests me more than the brand that comes. Then later on, I went to US, worked for big companies like Citicorp and Muse. Then life was so good. It was so good because I didn't have to work much. Anything that I have joined there as a senior consultant at Citicorp. So first, whatever the work, they used to be Monday meetings. And then for the entire week, whatever they used to tell us, we started with the same co-founder of the first company that I worked for in Bay Area. We started a company called Media Foundation. Media Foundation in 2001 is like a Google for videos and photos, speech. Okay? At that time, Google search, video search, image search was not there. Nothing existed of that kind. But attempting to do that video search was very fascinating. And then the language playing, everything came in place. But then we were too early, to cut the story short, we were too early for that kind of a product. Then we struggled for some time and then decided to close down. And then that's when I joined into TyE Hyderabad as a guest faculty first. And then when I was able to really connect with the technology that we had created and the experience that we got from the industry with the young engineers or the young students who are learning technology, then when they were able to connect with us in a much better way, connect with me in a much better way, I thought this is a better job. It's a better job because it can create more entrepreneurs, more engineers who can change the world. So one is you can create companies or you can create people who will create the companies, right? So educators have always a meta-level satisfaction. Then, but then entrepreneurial path didn't stop. Right? Once you enter this, once you know that you can become a very, the thrill, once you enjoy the thrill of working for smaller companies, doing great things, you can never do a regular job. So that's when we started another company called Setu Software Systems, which again built the first search engine for Indian languages. So which was deployed on Rediff, where you can actually search, put in Telugu or Hindi or Marathi, Kannada, any keyword you'll be able to get the results in all these languages. Okay. Then we moved on to do several other things. We created a product called Microna, and then we are now focusing on a social media platform called Views. Views is actually will tell you, will actually listen to all the social media platforms like Twitter, Facebook, Google Plus, YouTube, Pinterest, Tumblr, tens of them. Listens to all of them and watches what people do and then tell you what is the most interesting content in what people are doing about it. What are the most shared viewed photos, videos, okay. And then what are the news about which there are lots of buzz, things of that kind. So it's a content discovery platform. So that's what we do now. But then it's about what are the meta level learning from here. One thing is for sure, what I mentioned earlier is 10,000 hours of homework, collect enough dots so that you'll be able to connect them later. And the third important thing is, when you have a Forrest Gump, how many people have seen that movie? Okay, Forrest Gump. There is one, Tom Hanks says, life is like a chocolate box, right? When you open it, you don't know which chocolate that you get. So, you have a chocolate box. You may not get the exact chocolate that you are expecting, but there is certainly something else. If you are able to appreciate that, then you should actually be doing something different. Okay? Finally, what I wanted to say, God, God, by design, every day morning, He deposits about $86,400 in your bank deposit, in your bank account. $86,400. He did deposit the same amount in Barack Obama's account, in my account, in your account, anybody's account. Okay? Now you can take those $86,400, multiply that, make it more valuable, make it $1 million, make it $1 billion, or you can spend all of that and then actually lose. At the end of the day, you can have zero value. It all depends on how you plan to use that investment God made in you every single day. So those are the number of seconds that we have in a day. Right? So you can spend it on Facebook, you can spend it in watching the television, or you can spend it writing code for Facebook. Or you can create something better than Facebook. And then we become like a Mark Zuckerberg, who actually made use of his $86,400 of deposit, made it into hundreds of billions of dollars. So choice is in your hands. Okay? So I'll stop here. So we could have a few questions and then any thoughts, any comments?
And also some goodies that Rajiv got as well. There are quite a few left over.
So instead, how can I actually say, this is the image of the person, this is the guy. Now take me to that place in that video where this person appears. Okay? So I have a suspect. So now imagine police department having this technology where they have thousands of hours of the footage. Okay? But they don't know exactly whom to look for, where to look for, they have to sequentially look at all this. Instead, you can give a camera or a photograph of all their 500 suspects and then sequentially run all this and then only shortlist the clips in which the face matches with certain level of accuracy. So that is one of the use cases.
I remember Terminator, right? You know, when that guy, not looks up, right? And then he says, and then the image comes out.
Exactly. So there's one use case, but there's like several use cases of that kind in the B2B space, business to business space.
Follow-up questions?
So, a chocolate for you.
Thank you.
Why did you stop you were an entrepreneur, why did you come to teaching? Why did you go to wrestling?
Well, I don't see both of them quite different now. Like, entrepreneur will always need to learn. What else is a better place to learn than teaching? Otherwise, there's no motivation to learn. But as I said before, when you're teaching to the right set of people or teaching in vintage fashion, you have an opportunity to connect these dots in a much better way. Okay? I'll tell you why. If you are looking at a problem, right, you also are talking to 100 people in your classroom, and they all have a lot of energy, they all are trained well. Okay? So now you pose a question to them, saying that this is the opportunity, this is the problem, this is the challenge. Now can you solve? Okay, what are your ideas? Out of these 100, 10 people would seriously take a look at it, and 2 people actually will take a point where it's actually a very credible idea, credible solution to work further on. So that's the opportunity that exists only in the educational institutions. At the same time, if you are an entrepreneur, you have limited resources, you need to really struggle, survive, in every sense, right? So then you may not have time to experiment as much. So my goal is to power these entrepreneurs now, with the technology that we've been creating, and with the motivating the young minds to actually take up these jobs in startups. So I always tell my students, if you want to make money now, or you want to become famous in the short term, join in Microsoft's and Google's and Facebook's and the world. But if you want to be really famous and then know that how special you are, join the startup. That actually prompted me to actually, I want to say one more thing. In everybody's life, after you reach a certain stage, right, you know that there are a couple of best things that have happened. I'm sure after you grow up, you'll tell the story to the next generation. What are the two best things, or the three best things that have happened to you? I asked myself that question. One thing is not giving up studies, not really getting into the temptation of joining a job after my undergraduate study or a graduate study, but to go ahead and complete my PhD when I was very eager to learn and stay in the campuses, right? Without really getting used to money. Before I got used to earning money, I actually pushed myself, not pushed myself, I actually chose to go and complete my PhD. That gave me enough depth to do things what I'm writing later. Second thing that happened to me is to actually go to a startup and work when I have all the energy in the world. It was very quickly I realized
when I was working in New York, that that is not the job that I wanted to do, though it was paying much better and the time was paid. Okay. I went to Silicon Valley to work for a company which had only two employees before me, and they were not even sure whether they were able to pay me salaries after 3 months. I still joined them because, what are the reasons? I mean, at that time maybe I was foolish. I actually bought into their dream. Okay. I shared the same dreams as they were dreaming. Okay. Maybe that was foolish, but that is the best thing that ever happened to me, because after that, 5 years of life was such a roller coaster life. I could have joined an Oracle, I could have joined in other big companies at that time. I had offers in my hand. But had I joined in any of those, I don't know what thing life would have been, but I feel that was one of the best things that ever happened. So other thing I wanted to say, now that there are not too many questions, there's one mantra that I read very strongly. This is articulated very well by a professor in Harvard University called Malhotra. He teaches negotiation for Harvard MBAs. What he says is, quit often, quit early. Quit early, quit often. If I actually chose to do something, then I'm not too sure if I like it or not. If I don't quit it, how will I choose something that is right for me? Right? If I don't, and if I have the fear of quitting many things, how soon will I be able to reach my destination? So quitting early, something that you don't like, something that you don't really connect with that well, is very, very important. And quit early, because if you more you delay, further away you are going from your destination. And quit often until you find the right one. So for example, my New York jobs are something that I was able to quit early. Okay. If I had stuck there, maybe it would have definitely been different. So this is another thing that I strongly believe. Quit early, quit often.
Let's give a big round of applause. That's pretty much what we have for this video. I'm Lance Thur in the cafeteria. Sanjay, you live with parents in the day. It's the first day, so we need the parents to reach the cafeteria. Driver's pizza. We'll be around if you want to hang around and have more discussions. If you're all done, you want to take home, then you can take home and get home. Choice is yours. Okay?
So next Sunday, we're off for the stuff. We're going to move on together.
Alright, that's fine. So we will need some feedback on the session. You can write back to us on your email address. You can just write an email back and let us know what you think about the session, what you like, what you don't like, or how you want, whatever feedback data. Right? You can feedback comments.